thin fancy dies. In the cradle where it lies. And soaring fancies then, I begin it. Ding dong bell.
Sleep when he wakes, and creep into the jaundice cycle. Oh, my Antonia.
I do not. And just my heart that speaks. There are a sort of men whose visages do cream and mantle like a standing corn, and do a willful stillness entertain.
The purpose to be dressed in opinion, of wisdom, gravity, profound conceit. As one should say, I am Sir Oscar, and when I know my lips, let no thou walk!
Oh, my Antonia, I do know these.
Therefore, your reputed wise for saying nothing. But I'm very sure that they should speak with almost dazzled ears, which hearing them would call them out fools.
I thought you were a smart man.
But, fish not with this melancholy being for this fool culture, this many. Oh, I know.
Very well, I'll have my fish after dinner.
Well, we will leave you there for dinner, guys. I must be one of these same dumb wise men who actually are never let me speak.
Keep me company for 2 years, old man, I'm not going to come to the life of
anything now?
Gracia speaks an infinite deal of nothing, more than any man in all Venice. His reasons are like 2 grains of wheat given to 2 bushels of chaff. You shall see all day you find them, and when you have them, they are not worth the search.
Well, tell me now, what lady is the same whom you swore a secret pilgrimage that you today promised to tell me of?
It is not unknown to you, Antonia. How much I disabled my estate by something from a more swelling port than my faint means of gun continuum. Nor would not be mourned to be abridged from such an old grave. My chief guests come off from the gates when they march. Something too prodigal at that negation. To you, Antonia, I owe the most in money and in love. From your love, I have wanted to unburden all my parts and purposes.
All the debts I owe.
I pray you, good Bersanio, let me know it. And if it stand, as you yourself still do, within the eye of honor, be assured my purse, my person, my extremest means lie all unlocked to your officials.
In my school days, when I had lost my child, I shot his fellow of the selfsame fly, the selfsame way, which more advice what, find the other form. And by adventuring what I oft found for. I urge this childhood proof, because what follows is currencies. I owe you much, and I can build you back, which I always lost. If you please to shoot now, then I will that same way, as you did shoot me first. I do not doubt, as I will watch the aim, or to find you, or to bring your latter hazard back again. Thank you, as dead or first.
You know me well, and herein spend my time, while you got my love and circumstance. And out of doubt you do me now more wrong in making question of my uttermost than if you had made waste of all I have. Then do not say to me what I should do, that in your knowledge may be by me be done, and I am pressed unto it. Therefore speak.
In Belmont is a lady which she left, and she's fair and fairer than that word of wondrous virtues. Sometimes from her eyes I did receive fair, speechless messages. Her name is Portia. Nothing undervalued to Cato's daughter Brutus's Portia, nor is the wide world ignorant of her worth. For the four winds blowing from Infree boast renowned suitors, and her locks hang on her temples like golden fleece that make her seat Belmont gorgeous and strong, and many Jasons could have pressed upon her. For my Antonia, I have the means to build a writing place, one of them. My place is such trick that I should question the problem.
Thou knowest all my fortunes are at sea. Neither have I money, nor commodity, to raise a present sum. Therefore, go forth. Try what my credit can and Venice do that shall be wrapped, even to the uttermost, to furnish thee to Belmont. Fair Portia. For presently inquire, so will I, where money is, and I'll know which to make. You have it on my trust, or honestly?
By my troth, Mary, sir, my little body is weary of this great world. You would be sick, ma'am, if your miseries were in the same abundance as your good fortune, and yet, for what I see, they are. It is no mean heaven is therefore to be situated in the mean. Superfluity comes sooner by white hairs, but competency lives longer.
Oh, good sentences and well pronounced.
They would be better if well.
Oh, what time to do where it's easiest to know what I wish to do?
Temples have been churches and
poor men's cottages, princes' palaces.
Oh, it is a good divine that follows his own instructions.
I can easier teach 20 what will wish to be done.
Then be one of the 20 to follow mine own teaching.
Oh, the rain may devise laws for them.
By the hot temper!
Oh, leave the record decree!
Such a hair is happening for you to skip for the measures of good counselor, cripple!
Why, this reason is not in the fashion to choose me a husband.
Ah, me, the one choose!
Why may not be choose who I would,
nor refuse who I dislike, so is the will of her living daughter, guarded by the will of her
dead father.
Oh, is it not half there so that I cannot choose one more, refuse none?
Your father was ever virtuous, and holy men had their debt good inspirations. Therefore the lottery we have devised, in those three chests of gold, silver, and lead, whereof who chooses his meaning, chooses you. We know thou will never be chosen by what more is there in your affection towards any of these disciples that are already come. I pray thee, overname them. I will describe them, and according to my description, level in my affection.
First, there is the Neapolitan prince.
Aye, that's a cause indeed, for he loves nothing but talk of his
horse,
and he makes it a great appropriation to his own good parts, that he can shoe him himself.
I am much glad my lady, his mother, played false with a
smith. Then is there the Count of
he does nothing but
bad. As you should say.
And you will not help me choose.
Oh, he has many tears and he smiles not. I think he would do that.
The way being philosopher when he grows on me, girls, so full of unmemorably sad
business as you. I had rather been married to a dense head with a bone in his mouth and either of these. God defend me from these two.
How say you?
By the French rule, just you more. God pay him.
And therefore, let's fight for a man. Oh, in truth, I know it doesn't seem to be a mock of a tea. Why, he has a horse better than the Neapolitans.
But then the bad habit of
drowning and the sharp baton.
Oh, he's every man
and no man.
Oh, he falls straight into the periphery. Even fits with his own child. If I should marry him, I should marry 20 husbands!
Oh, if he would despise me, I would forgive him.
For if he loved me to madness, I will never requite him.
What say you then to your image?
He don't.
I see nothing to him, but he understands not me nor I him.
And he has neither Latin, nor French, nor Italian, and you will come to the court and swear I have a poor pennyworth in the English.
Oh, he's a proper man's picture.
But alas, who can converse with a dumb show? How would he suit him? I think actually what is double to Italy, round us in France, in point in Germany, and his behavior. Everywhere.
What's he doing?
Of the Scottish lord,
his neighbor.
But he has.
And they're only chanting him, but he bought a box of the young people and swore he would pay him back when he went able.
Oh, I see. Your French lord. I began his charity and sealed London for another.
How like you that young German, you Hugo Saxon's nephew?
Oh, very fine in the morning when he's sober. And If he should offer to choose, and choose the right casket, you should refuse to perform your father's will, if you should refuse to accept him. Therefore, for fear of rumors, I pray you set a dingy glass of Rhenish wine on the contrary casket. Oh, for if the devil be with you, then that temptation with him, I know he will choose it. I will do anything else, ere I will be mad to a sponge. You need not fear, Lady, that I have any of these girls. They have acquainted me with their determinations, which is indeed to return to their home, and to trouble you with no more suit, unless you may be one by some other sort, than your father's imposition depending on the caskets. If I live to be as old as Sibylla, I will die as chaste as Diana, unless I do a thing in the manner of my father. Oh, and yet these parts of your rumors are so reasonable. There's not one of them, but I dote on these very actions. And I would have got grant them a fair departure. Do you not remember, late, your father's service? A merchant, a scholar, and a soldier. Can you get there in the company of the Marquis of Montferrat?
Yes,
yes.
Oh, yes, I think so. Was he called?
True, he of all the men that ever my foolish husband was, was the best deserved of carriage.
Oh, I remember him well. And I remember him worthy of thy praise.
Come now, what news?
The four strangers seek you, madam, who take their leave. And there is a four other company of him, the Prince of Morocco, who brings while the Prince his master will be here tonight.
Thank you, Jesus, welcome with so good a heart as I can give the other four farewell. I should be glad if you were so.
We have the condition of the saint.
And the complexion of the devil.
I had rather he should try me than who I am. Come, Venice, there are more before. So why did we shut the gate upon one who would end up in love with the door?
As I told you, Antonia shall be bound.
Antonia shall become bound. Well,
may you send me, will you pleasure me, will you answer?
3,000 ducats for 3 months, and Antonia bound.
Your answer, that I
Antonia is a good woman?
Have you had any inquisition for the contrary?
Oh, no. My meaning in saying that she is a good woman is to have you understand me that she is sufficient. Yet her means are in supposition. She had an argosy bound to Tripoli, another to the Indies. I understand, moreover, upon the Rialto she had, that's Mexico, for England, and other ventures she had squandered abroad. But ships are but boats, sailors but men, baby, land rats and water rats, water thieves and land thieves, I mean, by rats. Then, name the fin pot, waters, winds, rocks. The woman is not been standing sufficient 3,000 ducats. I think I may make a one.
Be assured, you may.
I will be assured, I may. And that I may be assured, I will be thick, me. May I speak to Antonia?
If it please you to dine with us.
Yes. Do us many more to eat of the habitation which your prophet the Nether lacked. Conjure the devil into. I will buy with you, serve with you, talk with you, walk with you, and so following, but I will not eat with you, drink with you, no, pray with you. What do you come to read out when she comes here?
This is Signora Antonia.
How like a fawny publican she looks. I hate her, she's a Christian. But more, for that in low simplicity, she lends out money gratis and brings down the rate of usance here with us in Venice. If I can catch her once upon the hill, I will be but the insurance grudge I may have. She hates our segregation and she rails even there, where merchants most congregate on me. My bargains and my well but print, which she calls intellect. Cursed be my tribe if I forget her.
Shylock, you hear?
I am debating off my present store. And by the near guess of memory, I cannot instantly raise up the wrath to pull the 3,000 reserves. What is that? Chuba! A friendly Negro of my tribe to punish you. How many months do you desire? Rest you very good, Signora. Your worship was the last in our box. Shadow,
albeit I neither lend nor borrow by taking nor by giving of myself.
Yet,
to supply the right wants of my friend, I'll bring a customer. Is she ever possessed of how much you would?
Why, I'll be closing that hand for 3 months. Father, that poor girl! You told me so. Well, then your father will let me see. But here you. In thus you say you neither
lend
nor borrow upon advantage.
I do neither use it.
My mother often used to be half. The third possessor, I was the third.
And what of him? Did he charge interest?
No. Not take interest. Not as you would say directly. Interest? Mark. Jenkins, when I lay down in himself a compromise, that all the evenings which were streaked and fired should fall as Jacob's hire, the ewes, being rank, in the end of autumn turned to the rams. And when the work of generation was between these woolly breeders in the act, the skillful shepherds filled me certain walls. And in the doing of the deed of kind deed, stamp them up before the full of ewes who, then conceiving, did in eating time fall. Party colored lamb! And those were Jacob's. This was the way to trial, and he was blessed, and the prince is blessing his men. Still, if not, this was a venture, sir, that Jacob served for. A thing not in his power to bring to pass, but swayed and fashioned by the hand of heaven. Was this inserted to make interest good, or is your use in silver, or is your gold and silver used in run? I cannot tell. I make it bring as fast. But nothing, Cinderella. Mark you this, Bassanio. The devil can cite scripture for his purpose. An evil soul producing holy witness is like a villain with a smiling cheek, a goodly apple rotten at the heart. Oh, what a goodly outside falsehood had. 3,000 ducats is a good round sum. 3 months from 12 then. is the battle for our tribe. You call me misbeliever, cutthroat dog, and spit upon my Jewish gabardine and all, for use of that which is mine own. Well then, it now appears you need my help. Go to them. You come to me and you say, Shiloh, we would have money. You say so? You? That it wore your robe upon my head and put me as you spurn a stranger girl for your threshold money is your suit? What should I say to you? Should I not say?
A dog, money. Is it possible a girl can lend 3,000 ducats?
Oh, or shall I bend low and in a bonfire scheme with bated breath and whispering humble messages? Fair lady, you spit on me already to last. You spurned me such a day, another time you called me dog. And for these courtesies, I lend you thus much money.
I am obliged to call thee so again, to spit on thee again, spurn thee to it. Thou wilt lend this money.
Lend it not unto thy friends. For when his friendship take a breach of barren metal of his friends, but lend it rather unto thy enemy who would she break.
Thou mayest with better face exact the penalty.
Why? Look how you stall. I will be friends with you and have your love. Forget the shame that you have stained me with. Supply your present wants and take no thought of uses for my monies. This is kind I offer.
This is kindness.
This kindness will I show. Go with me to a notary. Sing me there your single bond. And to the merry spot. If you repay me not on such a day, in such a place, such sum or sums, as I expressed in the condition met, let the forfeit be nominated for an equal bound of your very flesh to be cut off and taken from what part of your body pleases me. Pretend in faith, I'll sign to such a bond. I say there is much kindness in the
Jew. Do not leave such a bond for me. I'd rather dwell in my necessity.
Fear not, man, I will not forfeit it. Within these 2 months, perhaps a month before the bond expires, I would better turn 5-3 times the value of the bond.
No further aid from what these Christians are, whose own hard dealing teaches them to suspect the thoughts of others.
Pray you, tell me this. If she should break her day, what should I gain by the exaction of a forfeiture? A pound of man's flesh taken from a man is not so profitable, estimable, neither as flesh of a mutton, beef, or goats. I extend this letter to my favor. If she will take it. So, if not, adieu. And for my love, I pray you wrong me not. Yes, Shylock, I will see that this bond. Well then, meet me forthwith at the notary's. Give him direction for this merry bond, and I'll go and burn the duck straight, and presently I'll be with you.
Hide me, gentle Jew. The Hebrew is no Christian. She grows kind.
I like a fair town than a villain's mind.
Come, in this day I've been more dismayed. My ships come home a month before the day.
The shadow of liberty of the world is done to the neighbor and the bread. Bring me the fair queen to the ball. Where feeble spires scarce fall. And let beg a favor, gentlemen, for your life. The room, whose blood is red? His? Or mine? I tell thee, lady, this aspect of mine hath feared the valiant. By my love, I swear, the best regarded virgins of our tribe have loved it too. I'm not ashamed of you, except to see your corpse. My gentle queen.
Oh, my lord, I am not totally led by the right direction of our maiden sight. Besides, the lottery of my head is far cleaner than I can afford it. Where is my father, and what can bring me in? Kiss me by his wings, to ease my his wife, and chosen me by that means my daughter. Self-renowned queen, then stood actually there, and any camera had to inform me as to my affection.
Even for that, I thank you. Therefore, I pray you lead me to the carpet to try my fortune. Bye! Oh, the sorry and virgin prince that won 3 fields of Sultan Soliman. I forbear the sternest eyes that look. I'll brave the heart who's staring on earth. Blood in your fucking cup from the she-mare. Yeah, muck the lion in a robe for prey. To win thee, late. But alas, the while, when Hercules and Lycus play at dust, which is the better man? The greater throne may turn by fortune from the weaker hand. And so may I, blind fortune leading me, miss that which one unworthy of me again, and though I can leave it.
Fair Jessica shall be my torchbearer. For Jessica,
ever. Why? Just as I say, why, Jerica? Who bids me call? I do not bid me call.
Oh, you were to whose wand and tell me I could do nothing without bidding.
Who are you?
What is your will?
Yeah, my keys, Jessica. I am being forced to suffer. But wherefore shall I go? I am not fit for love, they flatter me. But yet, I will go in hate to feed upon the prodigal Christian. Jessica, my girl, look to my house. I am right loath to go. There is some ill brewing towards my rest, for I did dream of money bags tonight.
Oh, I beseech you, ma'am, go! My young master does expect your reproach.
So do I, yes.
I say you conspired together. I will not say you shall see your mark, but if you do, then it was not for nothing that my nose fell at leaving on black man at last, for I think the car in the morning. Ha 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 ha
ha! What? How then, master? Here you be just now. Lock up my doors. And when you hear the drum and the wild squealing of the Rhine next fire, clamber not up to the casements then, nor thrust your head into the public street and gaze on Christian fools with varnished faces.
Here, catch this basket. It is worth the pain. I'm glad.
Nancy, you do not look on me, but I am not ashamed of my exchange. But love is blind, and lovers cannot see the pretty follies that themselves commit. If they could, Cupid himself would blush to see me thus transformed into a boy.
This ends. So you must be my torchbearer.
What? Must I have a dance of my shame? They themselves will soon are too light. Why, it is an object of discovery, love. And I should be obscure.
So are you, sweet. Even in the lovely eyes of the boy. Come, come, for the clothes I've tucked in the railway. And we are safe forever, Samuel, please.
I will make fast the door, then give myself with some more ducats and be with you straight.
By my hood, a gentle and no Jew, beshrew me. But I love her heartily. She is wise, but in judge of her. And fair she is, that mine eyes be true. True she is, she has proved herself. And therefore, like herself, wise, fair, and true. And she be placed in my constant soul. What? Art thou come? On, gentlemen, away! I must be made by this time for our stay.
Who's there? Signor Antonio.
Fie, Graciano. Where are all the rest? It is 9 o'clock, our friends all stay for you. No mask tonight, the wind has come about. Besides, everything will be going aboard. I have saved 20 hours of seat for you.
I'm glad on it.
I could have no more delight than to be on the safe. I'm going to ride.
Shall gain what many men desire. The second of silver, which this promise carries, who chooseth me shall get as much as he deserves. The third, dull red, with warning on his blood, who chooseth me must give and hazard all he has. How can I know I who choose life?
The one thing contains my picture.
God direct, my judgment. Let me see. I'll survey the inscriptions back again. What says this leaden casket? Who chooseth me must give and hazard all he hath. Must give. For what? For less. Hazard for less. This casket threatens. Men that have it all do it in hope of fair advantages. A golden mind stoops not to shows of dross. I'll then neither give nor have an aught for less. What says this silver with a virgin hue? Who chooseth me must shall get as much as he deserves. As much as he deserves. Pause there, Morocco, and weigh thy value with an even hand. If thou beest rated by thy estimation, thou dost deserve enough, and yet enough may not extend so far as to the lady. And yet to be afraid of my deserving were but a weak disabling of myself. As much as I deserve, like that's the lady. I do in birth deserve her, and in fortune, in graces, and in qualities of breeding. But more than given love, I do deserve. What if I strayed no further, but chose death? Let's see once more this same great room. Who chooses me shall gain what many men desire. What many men desire, why that's the lady. All the world desires her. From the four corners of the earth to come to kiss the shrine, this mortal breeding saint. The Hyrcanian deserts, the vasty wilds of wide Arabia are as thoroughfares now for princes to come and view. Fair Portia, the watery kingdom whose ambitious head spits in the face of heaven. Is no bar to stop those foreign spirits, but they come, as were a brook, to see Fair Portia. One of these three contains her heavenly picture. Is it like the blade contains her? To our damnation, to think so base a thought, to too gross to rib her cerecloth in that obscure grave. Oh, shall I think? In silver, see the mule, being 10 times wonder value to try gold. Ah, simple thought. Ne'er so rich a gem was set in worth and gold. We choose the theme, yet many men desire. Give me a peep on it.
There, take it, friends, and if my home lies there, then I'm yours.
Oh, hell! What's that? A carrion death! Within whose empty eye there is a written scroll. I'll read the writing. All that glisters is not gold. Often have you heard that joke. Many a man whose life has sold but my outside to behold. Gilded tombs do worms enfold. Had you been as wise as bold, young in limbs, in judgment old, your answer had not been in scroll. Fare you well, your suit is gold. Gold indeed, and labor lost. Then farewell heat, and welcome frost. Portia, adieu, I have to grieve to heart to take a deed of farewell, thus lose a spark.
Bessalion the sea, with him is Rashiana Bonalon.
An initiate, I'm sure Lorenzo is not.
The villain Jew and outcries, Lady Duke. Went with her to search Bessalion's ship.
She came too late. The ship was on the sea. But there the Duke was given to understand that in a gondola were seen together Lorenzo and his amorous Jessica. Besides, Antonio certified the Duke that they were not with Bassanio in his ship.
Oh, I never heard a passion so confused, so strange, so outrageous, and so bearable as the dog Jude uttered as traits. My daughter! Oh, my darling! Oh!
part for French and English. They always carry the vessel of our country richly shot. I thought upon Antonia when he told me. I wished in sadness that it were not hers.
Oh, you had best tell Antonia what you hear. Yet, do not suddenly, for it may grieve her.
Kind of lady treads not the earth. I saw Bassanio and Antonia part. Bassanio told her that he would make some speed of his journey. She answered, do not so. It's love and not business for my sake, but stay the very rising of the time. As for the Jew's bond which you have with me, let it not enter into your mind as well. See Mary, in a her chiefest thoughts, to courtship and such fair ostent of love as shall conveniently become the bed. Even there, her eye being big with tears, turning her face, she put her hand behind him, and with affection wondrous sensible, she wrung the Samuel's hand. So they parted.
I think she only wants the world for him. I pray thee, let us go and find her out, and quicken her embrace heaviness with some delight or the other.
Do we so.
I pray the Prince of Arabia had gained his oath and comes to his election presently. There stands the casket, no surprise. If you choose that, the very uncontained, straight shall our nuptial rites be solemnized. But if you fail, without more speech, my lord, you must be gone from hence immediately.
I'm enshrined by oath to observe three things. First, never to inform anyone which casket was I chose. Next, if I fail of the right casket, never in my life to woo any maid by way of my life. Last, if I fail the fortune of my shot, it is easy to leave you when we come.
Leading notions everywhere, that's where they come to have it for my work.
And so I address me, fortune now to my heart's hope. Gold, silver, and place then. Who shoots at me shall give an hazard all he has. You shall look fairer ere I give a hazard. What says this golden chest? Ah, let me see. Who chooseth at me shall gain what many men desire. What many men desire. That many may be led by the fool multitude, the fool by the church, not learning more than the fond eyed, which prize not to the interior, but like the market, bills in the weather on the outward wall. I will not choose what many men desire. Cause I'm not just with common spirit, and rank me with the barbarous multitudes. Why then to thee, my silver treasures? Tell me once more what it thou dost bear. Who shews at me shall get as much as he deserves. And well said too. For who shall go boot to cotton fortune and be on love with you to stamp of him? Let none presume to wear an undeserved dignity. Oh, that the staff, the grays, officers were not reaved corruptly, and the clear nerve were purchased by the merit of the wearer. How many then should coop to stand uncooped? How many be commanded that command? How much low peasantry would then be gleaned from the true seed of an heir, and how much an heir picked from the shaft and ruin of the times to be new varnished? But to my choice. As much as I deserve. I'll assume deserve. Still we make you for this.
Oh, too long a horse for that, did you find this?
What's here? The portrait of a blinking idiot presenting me with a schedule. I'll read the writing. How much unlike art thou to Portia? How much unlike my hopes and deserving? Who chooseth me shall get as much as he deserves. Did I deserve no more than a fool said? seven times tried these. Seven times tried that jugement these, that did never shoot the means. Some there be that shadows keep, such as the shadows be. There be fools that eat, I eat. Silver ore, and so was this. Take what wife you will to bed, I'll forever be your head. So be gone, you are spared. Still more fool I shall appear by the time I linger here. The one fool said I came to woo, but now I go away with two. Sweet, adieu. I'll keep my oath, but long live to bear my wrath.
Ancient seniors are heresy, hanging and wiring, go by destiny.
Come, Marissa.
Where is my lady?
Here, what about you?
Madam, there is a light in the showcase, a young Venetian, one that comes before to signify the approaching of his lord, to the whom he bring a sensible degree, to which besides commends and courteous rest, gifts of his valor. Yet I have not seen so lightly an ambassador of love. A day April, then an April, speak to show how costly summer was at hand. As this Bosper comes before his lord.
No more, I pray thee. I'm half feared thou is here on his son king to me. Thou spring with such high day with him praising him. Come, come, Marissa, for I long to see quick Cupid's footstep come so mannerly.
Bassanio, Lord love, if thy reach me.
Why, yes, it lived down there, that Antonia has a ship of Greeks sailing wrecked on the narrow seas. If my gossip reports be an honest woman, of course.
She was as mad as a gossip that has ever made her neighbors believe she wept for the death of a poor husband. But it is true, for that we live for felicity, or cutting the plain highway of talk, that the good Antonia, the honest Antonia, oh, that I had his life good enough to keep her name properly.
Come, the first time.
Oh, say it now. By the end of she had lost the ship.
I wouldn't mind proof the end of the losses.
I would say amen to that. Lest the devil cross my prayers. But here he comes. And my life never comes by the Oh, now, shine up. What news among the merchants? You knew. None so well as you of my daughter's life.
That's certain. I, for my part, knew the tailor that made the wings.
No, but shine up for her own part. Knew the bird was bleached. And then it is the complexion of the moon to leave the dance.
She is dead for it. That's certain. If the devil may get us.
My own flesh. To rebel. Oh, what funny old dragon.
Rebel, they have been here.
I say my daughter's my flesh and blood.
There is more difference between thy flesh and hers than between jet and ivory. More between your blood than between red wine and French. Tell us, do you know whether Antonia has had any loss of sea or not?
There. I have another bad match. A bankrupt, a prodigal, who dares scarce show her head on the Rialto. So better. Let us use to come so smug upon the mast. Let her look to her bond. She was wont to call me usurer. Let her look to her bond. She was wont to lend money for Christian mercy. Let her look to her bond.
Why, I am sure, if she forbid, thou wilt not take her flesh. What's that good for?
Thank you.
guess it will fit my revenge. She has hindered me half a million. Laughed at my losses. Mocked at my gains. Scorned my nation. Thwarted my bargains. Fooled my friends. Hated my enemies. And what's the reason? Huh? I am a Jew! Have a Jew life? Have a Jew hands, organs, dimensions, senses, affections, passions, fed with the same food, hurt with the same weapons, subject to the same diseases and healed by the same means, warmed and cooled by the same winter and summer as a Christian is. If you prick us, do we not bleed? If you tickle us, do we not laugh? If you poison us, do we not die? If you wrong us, shall we not revenge? If we are like you in the rest, we will resemble you in that. If a Jew or a Christian, what is his humility? Revenge. If a Christian wrong a Jew, what should his sufferings be? My Christian example, why? Revenge. The villainy you teach me, I will execute, it shall go hard. But I, with better instruction.
Oh, here come another of the tribe. The third cannot be matched on this much ever himself done, Jew!
How about you, boy? What news from Genoa has not happened to my daughter?
I often came when I stayed here, Arthur. But cannot find her.
Why? There. The time has come. Cost me 2,000 ducats of strength, but the first little bit on our nation till now I never felt it till now.
2,000 ducats!
Precious, precious jewels! I put my daughter to death if I put in the jewels in her ear, would she go hard if I put in the ducats in her coffin? No news of them? Why so? And I know not what's spent in the search.
Why, now?
Loss upon loss. The thief gone. With so much and so much to find the thief. And no satisfaction, no revenge. Nor no enough. Stirring but what lies on my shoulders, no. Sighs but on my breathing. Tears but on my shame.
Others have been laughed too. Antonia, that heard in Genoa, has an arbitrary cast.
What? What would you look in that?
Has an arbitrary cast away coming from Tripoli.
Thank God. Thank God, is it true? Is it true?
I spoke with some of the sailors that escaped the wreck.
Oh, thank me, good you, man. Oh, good you. Heard in Genoa?
Your daughter spent in Genoa, as I heard one night. Four ducats.
The stick is the dagger in me, Jubal. I shall never see my gold again. Four score ducats of the city. Four score ducats.
There came divers of Antonia's creditors in my company to Venice, but swear she cannot choose but break.
I am very glad of it. I'll blame her. I'll torture her. I'm glad of it.
One of them showed me a ring that he had of your daughter. For a monkey.
Oh, Tupana! It was my turquoise. I had it on my husband's arm.
for a wilderness of monkeys.
But Antonia is certainly undone.
Nay. That's true, that's it. Go to me, Juba. Feed me, officer. We speak in a fortnight before.
I will have to hire a worksheet for Crete. For were she out of Venice, I can make what merchandise I will.
Go, Juba. Leave me at our synagogue, Juba. No! Good Juba! Have our synagogue, Juba!
And corrupt, but they see them with the the gracious voice obscures the shore. Religion, watch down the river with some sober brow and visage, and approve it to the text, hiding the crossness of their ornament. There is no vice so simple, but assumes some mark of virtue on its outward parts. How many cowards whose hearts are all as false as tears of sand, wear yet upon their chins, here's the Hercules and frowning Mars, who inward searched at livers, might smint. And these assume the fallacious excrement to render them redoubted. Look on beauty, and you shall see it is purchased by the weight, which therein works a miracle in nature, making them lightest that were most of them. So are those crisp and snaky golden locks, which make such wanton gambols with the wind on supposed fairness, even known to be the dowry of a second head, the skull that bred them in the sepulchre. This ornament is but a guile short for most dangerous see. The beauteous scarf, only Indian beauty. In a word, the seeming truth, which cunning times put on to entrap the wisest. Therefore, thou body gold, hard food for Midas, tired and unhealthy. Nor none of thee, thou pale and common drudge between man and man. But thou meager lead, which rather threatenest than dost promise aught, thy painless moves thee more than eloquence. Here to thy toy be the consequence.
What of the passion leads to wicked, shuddering fear and rushing their despair and doubtful thoughts and green-eyed jealousy? Oh, love. Be moderate, allay thy ecstasy, in better
aid
thy joy, scarcely
be successful.
Yes,
for thee arise, O thee. What find I here? Fair Portia's counterfeit! What demigod hath come from your creation? Move these eyes, however seem they in motion. Here are severed lips, parted with sugar brim. So sweet a bar should sunder such sweet friends. In her hair is the painter placed a spider, and hath woven a golden mesh to entrap the hearts of men faster than gnats in cobwebs. But her eyes, how could he see to do them? Having made one, methinks it should have power to steal both his and leave itself unfurnished. Yet look how far the substance of my praise hath wrongly shadowed in underprizing it, so far the shadow doth put behind the substance. Here is the scroll, the continent and summary of my fortune. You that choose, not by the view, chance is fair and chooses true. Since this fortune falls to you, be content and seek it on you. If you be well pleased with this, and hold your fortune for your bliss, turn to where your lady is and claim her with a loving kiss. The gentle scroll, fair lady, by your leave I come by naught, to give and to receive. And one to contending in a prize, in thy well in people's eyes, turning applaud and universal shout, giving spirit, still gazing in a doubt, whether those pieces of praise is or no. So try fair lady, stand I even so, as doubtful, as though I see it true, until confirmed, signed, ratified by you.
You see me, Lord Bassanio, where I stand, such as I am. And for myself alone, I would not be ambitious in my wish to wish myself much better. Yet for you I would be triple, 20 times myself, or 1,000 times more fair, 10,000 times more rich. And only to stand high in your account I might in virtues, beauty, living strength. But the full sum of me is some of something. Mr. Turpin, gross, is an unlessened girl, unschooled, unpracticed. Happy in it that she's not yet so old, but she may learn. That she's ready, not so dull, but she can learn. It's to fall in that a gentle spirit commits itself to yours to be directed.
As from a lord, a governor, a king. Myself and what is mine to you and yours is now converted. But now, I was the lord of this fair mansion. Master of my servants, queen on myself. Now, but even now, this house, these servants, and this same myself, my lord, my lord. So I give them to you with a dream. Which when you act from, lose all, give away. Or let it be safe to ruin of your love and me, my vengeance to exclaim on you.
Madam, you have break your whole word. Only my blood seeps in my veins. Such confusion in my heart. Some oration fairly spoke. My beloved prince, in that of your buzzing, please at multitude. Something being led together, comes to nothing that they before expressed, cannot express. But then the king passing his finger, life passing hand, then we both to say the sign is dead.
My lord and lady, it is now our turn. Let us stood by and see now which is prosper. To cry, good joy, my lord and lady.
Well, of the sun, and my gentle lady, I wish you all the joy that you can wish, for I'm sure you can wish none for me. And when your honours mean to solemnize the bargain of your fates, I do beseech you, even at that time, I may be married too.
With all my heart, so thou can get a wife.
I thank your lordship. You have got me one. My eyes, my lord, can look as swift as yours. You have a mistress. I become a maid. You love, I love. Intuition no more pertains to me, my lord, than you. Your fortune stood upon the casket there. And so did mine too, as an unfalls. For who in here did I sweat again? And swearing to my very roof was trial of oaths of love, my love. Promise love. I got the promise of this fair one here to have her love. Provided your fortune achieved her mistress.
Oh, is this true, Nerissa? Madam, it is. Will you stand, please, your lord?
And do you, Graciano, mean good faith?
Yes, faith, my lord.
Happy shall be much honored in your marriage.
We shall give them the first boy for a thousand others.
What in stay down?
No, we shall never win a dance for the stay down. No, who comes here? Lorenzo is in there. What, and the whole direction is Cancellario.
Lorenzo! Cancellario, welcome hither. The youth of my new intention and part of it, you welcome. By all these, I bid my many friends and countrymen sweet Portia welcome.
So
do
I, my lord,
they
are entirely welcome.
I thank your honor. For my part, my lord, my troubles is not to have seen you here. But Mr. Valerio, by the way, he did accuse you.
Bastards!
He comes to mother.
I did, my lord, and there are reasons for it. Signor Antonia, comes to you.
And I hope, Valerio, I pray you tell me how much you spend up.
Not sick, unless it be mine. Nor well, unless in mine. Her letter there will show you a thing.
There is a curious stranger bit of welcome. Your hands, Valerio. On the good Venice. How's the good merchant around Antonia? I'm sure she will be glad of my success. We have Jason's. We have won the fleece.
I would you have won the fleece, that she has lost.
There are some shrewd contents in you on the same paper. She took out from Bessandro's chief. So, dear friend, Dave. In the world who does so much the constitutionary constant man. What worse than worse? Obviously, Bassanio, I am half yourself, and I must really have a half of anything that this same breaker brings you.
Sweet Portia, incur out of you the unpleasantest words that ever blotted paper. Gentle lady, when I did first impart my love to you, I freely told you that all the wealth I had ran in my veins. I was a gentleman, and then I told you true. Yet, dear lady, rating myself at nothing, you shall see how much I was a braggart. When I told you I was nothing, I should have told you I was worse than nothing. For indeed, I have engaged myself to a dear friend. Engaged my dear friend to her mere enemy to feed my means. The paper is the body of my pen, every word in it a gaping wound issuing lifeblood. But is it true, Salerio? Have all the adventures failed? What of one hit? From Tripoli, Mexico, England? From Lisbon, Barbary, and India? Not one vessel escaped the jet
simple touch of mercenary knots?
Not one, my lord. And besides, it should appear that if she had the present money to discharge the Jew, she would not take it. Never did I know a creature that did bear the shape of man, so keen and greedy to confound a man. She plies the Duke at morning and at night, and does impeach the freedom of the state if they deny her justice. 20 merchants, the Duke himself, and the magnificos of the greatest port have all persuaded with her. But none can drive her from the envious speed of forfeiture, of justice, and her bond.
When I was with her, I heard her swear to chew on and to cast her countrymen. And she would rather have Antonia less than 20 times the value of the sum than she did owe her. And I know, my lord, that in law, authority, and power, deny not, it will go hard with poor Antonia.
Is it your dear friend that it doesn't trouble?
The dearest friend to me, the kindest, the best conditioned and unwearied spirit in doing courtesies, and one in whom the ancient Roman honor more appears than any that draws breath in Italy.
What sum was she to you?
For me, 3,000 ducats.
What? No more? A bear! 6,000 and debased upon! Double 6,000 and then shiver that before a prisoner! This description shall lose hair too. Bessario's fault. Oh, first come with me to church and call me wife, and then away to Venice to your friend. For never shall you like my torch here side with an unquiet soul. You shall have balls to pay the 20 debts 20 times over. And when it is paid, bring your true friend along. My maidens and myself, meantime, will live as maids and widows. Oh, come away, for you shall hasten upon your wedding day. Bid your friends welcome.
Show a maid here.
Yes, you are. Dear, what?
I will love you, dear. But let me hear the letter of your friend.
Sweet Bassanio, my ships have all miscarried. My creditors go cruel. My estate is very low. My bond to the Jew is forfeit. And since in paying it, it is impossible I should live. All debts are clear between you and I. If I might, but see you at my death, notwithstanding, use your pleasure. If your love do not persuade you to come, let not my letter.
Love,
dispatch
your business and leave
home. Since I have your good leave to go away, I'll make haste. But till I come again, no bed shall I be guilty of my stay, nor let it be in the home of the fear of that pain.
I have no speaking. I have my bond.
Whatever
most impenetrable girl I ever kept with, man.
Let her alone. Follow her no more with your prayer. She seeks my life. There isn't well, I know. I oft delivered from her forfeitures many that have at times made moan to me. Therefore she sits.
I am sure the Duke will never grant this forfeiture to all.
The Duke cannot deny the court's law. For the commodity that strangers have without the menace, if it be denied, will much impeach the justice of the state. Since that the trade and profit of the city consists of the whole nation. The griefs and losses have forfeited me that I shall hardly spare a pound of flesh tomorrow to my family. Pray God Bassanio come to see me say his death, and then I can.
Men shall swear
I have discontinued school about 12 months.
So I have in my mind a thousand or six of these dragging jacks which I will practice.
Why? Shall we turn to men?
Oh, fine! What a question is that?
Is our wet near a new interpreter?
But Sam, I'll tell you on my own device when I'm in my profit of taste for act of the park kid. Oh, never mind, you'll be coming.
What's the matter? 20 miles today!
Heavenly match, and all the major ladies of the world would have been a quarter of one.
There must be something else formed with the other. For the poor world has not her better.
Even such a husband has doubt me as she is her wife.
Nay, but ask my opinion to of that.
I will alone.
First let us go for dinner. Nay, let me pay you while I have it.
Nay, let it serve a thing. Then how can I not speak of among other things? I shall digest it.
Where I set you for.
Why he? A woman man fight, but of course.
such inevitable shame as to offend himself being offended.
Jacques, can I?
Give no reason, nor I will not. More than a lot, hate. A certain loathing I bear in Dunia that I follow thus. A losing suit against her. I want, sir.
This is no answer, thou unfeeling woman, to excuse the current of thy cruelty.
I am not bound to please thee with my answers.
Go on and kill the things that you don't love.
Hate any man the thing he would not kill.
Every offense is of a hate, Akbar.
What? Wouldst thou have a certain thing thee twice?
I bear you think you question with a jewel. You may as well go stand upon the beach and pick the means that face with you to the You may as well be questioned with the wood. One hath made a ewe bleat for the land. You may as well forbid the mountain pines to wag their high tops and make no noise when they are threatened with the dust of heaven. You may as well do anything more hard and keep something that and which was hard, the Jewish heart. Therefore I do beseech you make no more offer, use no further means, but with all grief and pain and expediency, let me have judgment. And would you hope it?
For my 3,000 ducats, there are 6.
If every ducat is 6,000 ducats, whether it's 6 pounds and every 5 ducats, I would not draw, then I would have my bond.
How shalt thou hope for mercy, rendering none?
What judgment shall I get? Doing no wrong? You! Have among you many Thou slave, which, like your asses and your dogs and your mules, you use as abject and slavish bars because you fuck them. Shall I think you'll ever be free? Neither of you heirs, why?
Tread they under burdens? Let their beds be made as soft as yours. Let their feathers be seasoned with such fire as you.
You? Oh, you will answer? The slaves are ours. So do I unto you. The bond of flesh, which I command of her, is dearly bought. 'Tis mine and I will have it. If you deny me, why, on your own, there is no force in the decrees of Venice. I stand for judgment. And the
time! Upon my power, I may dismiss this court. Unless Bellario, a learned doctor whom I have sent for to determine this from your grave, your priest, let's change the path. With letters from the doctor.
New counsel on fire.
Bring us the letters, call the messenger.
Good journey, what courage is that you should have my flesh, blood, bones and all, that thou should lose for me one drop of blood.
I am a tainted vessel of blood, meanest to the head. The weakest kind of thing drops her to the ground. You cannot better be employed, Bassanio, than to live still and right by it.
Come you from Padua, from old Bellario, from old Bellario Greek to the
Why don't you wait by night so earnestly?
Because the sausage is in the tent up there.
My soul asked you, thou make thy knife keen. But go back again, the one that has that. Their heart is the sharpness of thy keen envy. Can your prayer fear thee?
No. None that thou hast wit enough to me.
Be thou damned, sacral dog! And in thy hand the justice and use. Thou art most gracefully reverent by this to hold the opinion of Pythagoras, that spirits of animals infuse themselves into the trunks of men. Thy gutter spirit governed the wood that was hanged for you from the rock. Even from the gallows of the smell of sword bleed, and while thou lives in that unhallowed land, you infuse yourself to thee. Thy desires are foolish, bloody, starved, and
ravenous! Do thou exhale the seed from off my bone? Thou but a
speak so loud. Repair thy wits with you.
What is the thought to cure swim?
I stand here for more.
This letter from Bellario, that comment,
a young Danish doctor to our court,
tells me he has entered your heart by to know your answer.
Whether you admit? With all my heart. Now, three or four of you, go and give him back his conduct to his place. Meantime, four shall hear Bellario's letter.
Oh. Your Grace shall understand that as a receipt of the letter, I am very sick. But in the instance that your messenger came, in loving visitation was with me a young daughter of Rome, his name is Balthazar. I am going to lift the cause and controversy between the Jew and Antonio the Merchant. We turned over many books together. He is furnished with my opinion, which better with his own learning, the greatness whereof I cannot enough commend, comes with him at my importunity to fill up your Grace's request in my stead. I beseech you, let his last years be no impediment to let him last there in destination, for I never knew so young a walking and so old a head. I leave it to your gracious acceptance, whose trial shall best accomplish his commendation. You hear the man of Bellario, what he writes, and this I take it is a long account. Come in from Calabria, from Bellario.
I think you are ready.
Give me your hand. You are welcome. Take your place. I am acquainted with the difference that holds the present question in the court.
I am informed, how of your report. Which is the merchant here and the Jew?
Antonia and Oshaya. Both stand for.
Is your name Shylock?
Shylock is my name.
Well, the strange nature is the suit you follow.
Yet seeing that such a rule as a Venetian law cannot impugn you as you.
You stand within her danger, do you not?
Aye, so she says.
Do you confess the bond?
I do.
Then must the Jew be merciful, for what compulsion must our under be that?
The quality of mercy is not strange.
In dropping this gentle rain from heaven upon the place to me.
It is Christ's blessing. It blesses him that gives and him that takes.
Mightiest in the mightiest, it becomes a throne monarch better than his crown.
His scepter shows the force of temporal power, the attribute to awe and majesty, wherein justice, the dread and fear of kings. But mercy is above the scepter's sway. It is enthroned in the hearts of kings. It is an attribute to God himself. And earthly power doth then show light in God, when mercy seasons justice. Therefore, Jude, for justice be thy plea, let Celeste, that in the cause of justice,
none of us should see salvation. We do pray for mercy, and that same prayer that teaches all to render the deeds of mercy.
I have spoken thus much to mitigate the justice of thy plea. If thou follow this strict course, then it must needs be sentenced against the man himself.
What a deed is upon my head! I pray the Lord that better deeds for me than my bond!
Is she not able to discharge the money?
Yes, dear, I gave it for her to court. Give twice the sum. That will not suffice. I will be bound to pay 10 times over on 4 feet of my hands, my head, my heart. This will not suffice. It must appear that malice bears sound fruit. And I beseech you rest once the Lord your authority. Do a great right to a little wrong. And curb this cruel devil of a wind.
It must not be. There is no power in Venice can order a victory established.
It will be recorded for a precedent, and many men of our
staring circle will rush into the state. Oh, it's
dark.
Thrice thy money offered thee.
Shall I wear third uniform my soul no not for Venice?
Why this bond is forfeited lawfully by this that you may claim a pound of flesh to be by her cup of tea as the merchant's heart?
You must suppose thrice thy money will be tear the bond.
When it is paid, according to the tenor, it does appear you are a worthy judge. You know the law, your exposition has been more sound. I tell you by the law, you are not here a well deserving bidder, proceed to judgment.
By my soul, I swear, there is no force in the tongue of man to order me.
And stay here on my bond.
Most heartily you are deceived, the court who gives the judgment.
Why then thus it is. You must prepare your bosom for her night.
Judge. Oh, excellent.
For the intents and purposes, the law has full relation to the penalty which here appeareth due upon the bond.
It is very true. Oh, why is an upright judge? How much more end than our dark and our looks?
Therefore, lay there your wisdom.
Aye. Arrest. So, says the body, that would not know the judge. Nearest the heart, those are the gay lights.
It is so.
I want here to weigh the flesh.
I have
ready.
But have I some servants lined up on your charge to stop her wounds lest she be.
Is it so nominated in the bond?
Oh, it is not so expressed, but what is that?
You so much for
charity.
It is not in the bond, I cannot find it.
You mustn't have you anything to say.
But if I am armed and well prepared, give me your hand to stand your feet.
Grieve not that I have fallen to this for you, for Harry Potter shows herself more kind than is her custom. It is still her use to lift the wretched man out of his bed, to view with hollow eye and wrinkled brow and even nostrils. From which lingering penance that she
comes here.
Commend me to your honor, my wife. There are the process of Antonio saying to say how I am not stupid, speaking there and yet. And when the fear is told, bitter be judged, whether the son of my love wants or not. Repent but you that you shall lose your head, and she repents not that you face your head. For if the truth of that is enough, a patient should be with all my
heart. Then, Tony, I have married to a wife, which is as dear to me as life itself. But life itself, my wife, and all the world, not to be esteemed about thy life. And to lose all, to sacrifice them all to this end.
Your wife won't give you a little thanks for that. She will buy you here, you may see your
heart. My wife, why don't you let that out? I wish you were in heaven before she went through
some ball of change of stomach.
It is well you opened behind her back. I wish she would make else in our quiet house.
Please, be the Christian husband.
I have a daughter.
Would any of the stock of violence have been a husband rather than a Christian? You try to time. I pray thee, pass your sentence.
A pound of this Samaritan's flesh is thine. The court above it, and the Lord hath given it.
Look, I do judge.
And you have stuck this flesh off from her breast. The Lord hath it.
Come.
Prepare. Oh, Jared, there is something else. This bond doth give thee here a no drop of blood. The words especially are a pound of flesh.
Take them, my God, take thine a pound of flesh, but
in come.
trusting it, if thou dost shed one drop of Christian blood, thy knights and looks upon the Lord of Venice come to get on the state of Venice.
Oh, upright judge, mark you! Oh, learned judge,
is that all? Master Shantivia, and thou art
justice!
Be assured thou shalt have justice, more than thou desirest.
Oh, learned judge, mark you! The learned touch.
I think something. Pay the ball price. And let the Christian go.
Here is the money.
So, the two shall have all justice. So, no hence, she shall have nothing but the penalty.
Oh, Jude! An upright touch. Learned.
There will be very little of the flesh. Shed thou no blood, and no one cut thou, less nor more, but just a pound of flesh. If thou takest more, or if there are just found, be but so much as makes it light or heavy in the suffering. Or the division of the 20th part of one poor scruple. No, if the scale do turn, but in the estimation of the head,
all right. Lord, I'll put that on his head. Second Daniel. The Daniel. Now, in the air. I am
from the hill. Why doesn't you say thy poor creature? Give me my principal and let me go.
I have it ready for the jurists.
She has refused giving me all before she shall have me. I need justice and I.
But Daniel still says, second Daniel. I can't be you for teaching me that word.
Shall I not unbury my principal? Thou shalt have nothing but thy poor Peter to be so taken at thy very.
Why? The devil is giving good.
I will say no further question. Oh, Daniel, do the law has yet another call. It is enacted in the law of Venice, if it be proved against an alien, that by direct or indirect attempt he seek the life of any citizen, the party against which he doth comply shall seek one half his goods. The other half comes to the true corporate of the state, and the offender's life lies in the mercy of the duke only against all other blasts.
In which they commend thy sin, thou stand.
Now you are proceeding that indirectly and directly do thou act and strive to get the very life of the defendant, and thou hast incurred the danger properly by the gate hearts. Come down that one then, Marcy!
Better thou shalt leave to hand thyself. And yet, the man has been forfeited to the state. Thou hast not let the hand of the court. Therefore, thou art the hand of the state's judge.
As thou shalt see the difference of our state, we pardon thee thy life before thou ask it. For half thy wealth it is Antonio. The other half comes unto the general state, which humbleness may drive unto a fight.
I for the sake of friend for ya.
Think that two fathers are mad. You take
my house. Please.
What dost thou say?
give me leave to go from Venice. Send the lead after me and I will sign it.
Yes, Igor. You must do it.
At that christening, thou shalt have two more fathers. And I be the death thou wouldst have had 10 more to bring to the gallows, not to the pot.
Thank you.
The moon shines bright.
In summer night, Troilus methinks mounted the Trojan walls,
and sighed his gold to a Grecian face,
the crescent in that night.
Such a night, it's this thing. Fair Cleon shifted to you, and saw nine shadow air set, and red.
In such night, stood Dido with a willow in her hand, upon the wild sea banks, and walked her love.
Come again, couple.
In such a night did Jessica steal from the wealthy Jew, and her outfit now had run from Venice as far as Belmont.
In such a night did young Lorenzo swear he loved her well, stealing her soul with many vows of faith and snares of true ones.
In such a night did crazy Jessica, that was the truth, surrender her love, and he forgave her.
Without respect, we think it sounds much sweeter than by day.
silence bestows a word to one another. The crow doth sing as sweetly as the lark when neither is attentive. And I think that the nightingale, if she should sing by day when every goose is cackling, could be thought no better musician than the wren. How many things by season, seasoned are to their right place?
Please, I'll have a speech with him, give it and would not be awake.
That is the voice, or I must see the Portia.
He knows me as the blind man knows the cuckoo by the bad voice. We have been praying for our husband's best carriage to speak with your better brown wife. Are
you tired?
No, we're not
yet. There is no message to report to you about it. I mean,
go in, yes, sir. Give order to my servants that they take no note at all of our being absent here. Where's the Lord, you petty up? Not you!
Thank you.
me what to believe.
I'd die for it. Who am I happening?
No, by my honor, madam, I am so long. I'm a civil doctor, which introduced 3,000 buckets of meal to make the ring, for which I did deny it and suffered into God's speech away. Even he that had led up the very life of my dear friend. What should I say to you, lady? I was then forced to send it after him. I was beset with shame and thirst. My honor would not let ingratitude so much be smeared. Pardon me, good lady. For by these blessed candles of the night, in their eyes you would have begged the ring of me. If there were a doctor.
If not a doctor ever come near my house.
He had a jewel that I love, and if you did swear to give to me, I will become as liberal as you. I'll not deny him anything I have, no amount of my body nor my husband's name. No, him I shall. I'm not sure of it. Oh, now by my honor, but yes, my own. I'll have that doctor for my bedfellow. And I was glad that he advised how you to leave me to my own protection.
Well, do you so? Let not me take him then, for if I do, I mar the young class then.
I am the unhappy subject of these quarrels. Madam, grieve not so for me, notwithstanding.
Portia, pardon me, Saint Faustin, and in the hearing of my many friends, I swear to thee. By dying on eyes when I see myself.
Oh, Matthew, what's that? He falls my eyes, he doubly sees himself. He may die one. I swear by your double seven, there's an old credit.
Nay, but hear me, pardon me this fault. And by my soul, I swear, I never more will beg an old
I want to lend my body to his death. But for him that has your husband's ring, has the right to scatter. I dare vow to bear my soul upon the poppy, that your lord will never more break faith with my sister. Then you shall be his surety. Isn't this? And we think he will be better than the other. Dear Robin Daniel, swear to his sister.
By heavens, it is the same, my dear doctor.
I have it of him. Oh, pardon me, Miss Samuel, for by this ring the doctor lay with me.
Why? This is like mending of hide in summer when the waves are fair enough. What? Are we got all there now?
No, you have so grossly. But you are all amazed. Here is the letter. Read it at your leisure. It comes from Padua from Bellario. There you shall find that Portia was the doctor. And there is a letter to write. Well, you're the witness. I'll send for the children. But now it's time. I have not escaped danger at my house. Antonia, you are welcome to my house. And I intend to use it to show you the next day. And see the next. There you shall find the three of your armies we have reached in that to harvest suddenly. Oh, you shall not know how what strange accident has come from this letter. I am done.
Who are you, the doctor, and I knew you not?
Are you the clerk that is to make me?
I, but the clerk who never means to do it unless he lives and you feel mad.
See, doctor, my bedfellow, when I am absent, you can lie with my wife.
Please, will you be my son? For here I mean for certain that your ships are getting on the coast. My clerk has some good comfort to you. I am give them his love. There do I give to you and Jessica from the rich too, a special deal after the death of all three men.
Fair ladies, you drop manna in the way of starved people.
Oh, it is almost morning, and yet I'm sure you are not satisfied with these events of home. Oh, let us go in.
They charge us upon interrogatory,
and we will answer all this faithfully.
Let it be so. The first indication that my arrest at this form is whether they were next night she had run away, or won't they now? In 2 hours then.
Here they come, close to me, can I be so proud she well, as I live, I'll fear not a thing.
the soul. As Keating said, there is a great
or in the heart or in the head. I've
I would also like to
especially thank everybody at Maximalabala for being so generous with everything, particularly Simon Metz, Mr. Raju Raman, Mr. Maiti, Mr. Ghosh, and also I particularly wish to thank Shylock's parents. Large degree helped by that. Thank you so much for coming. Good night.